Good afternoon, Coronado, and welcome back to another episode of Cougar TV. I'm Maxwell Howland.
And I'm Christian Morrow. As the students and staff of Coronado prepare for Halloween, many have traditions that they enjoy.
Halloween is quickly approaching, and we thought we would find out what students and staff love about Halloween.
My favorite thing about Halloween? Probably the costume.
The spookiness.
The scariness.
The amount of, like, horror.
Carving pumpkins.
It's probably hanging out with my friends.
Enjoying your time with, like, people.
Trick-or-treating for the candy.
The weather.
The candy.
Dressing up and going out with friends.
Hanging out with my friends and my family.
Every day feels just a little spooky.
It's my birthday. Growing up, Halloween was always my favorite because everybody celebrated my birthday.
My favorite thing about Halloween is seeing the little kids in all their cute little costumes.
My favorite thing about Halloween is dressing up. My all-time favorite year, my family, we did Coco, the Disney movie. At the time, my current five-year-old, I think she was three, she was Mama Coco, and so it was really cute.
Sounds like everyone is looking forward to a spooky weekend, and an early happy birthday to Mr. Stoughton.
As the school year progresses, students' classes get increasingly harder. It's possible some may even need some help.
Mr. Bowers in the Help Center is here and ready to help any students in need.
The Help Center opens the beginning of the day, so 7:40 at the beginning of the day every day, and then it closes normally at 3 o'clock when the day ends, but on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Thursdays, I'm still here until 4 o'clock for anyone who needs help after school. Anyone can go to the Help Center. We specialize in helping in math, so Algebra 1, geometry, stuff like that, but we also are open to helping other students depending on what my tutors are able to help in. So I see what they first need help with, depending on if they just need help getting missing assignments in on a certain concept or on helping on a certain homework assignment. And then we set them up with a tutor. They help them by going through the problems. And then we check for understanding just to make sure that hopefully when they leave, they are not just getting a grade for that homework assignment, but they also are learning that concept. So that when they go to the test eventually, they are able to do well on it.
Come on down to the Help Center in room 7 and get some help, because I know I need it.
During the month of September, COVID cases were rising, which led to Coronado releasing a school-wide mask mandate.
Students and teachers have had to adjust accordingly. The mask mandate has now been extended through the end of semester 1.
It's affected in the sense that there's a lot of enforcement pieces, so that was directed by our district, so we have to enforce it, and for the most part everybody's really pretty good and wears their masks and follows the directions. So a bright side of the mask mandate is we haven't had to do any quarantines. So that has changed my job for the better, because it was a lot of work and it wasn't fun quarantining people. So
in my opinion, that I think we should just keep them on and saves us from going back online. So yeah, I think we should keep them on.
I think the mask mandate is good because we can get rid of the virus. I think the mask mandate will last at least maybe another year or so.
I think two quarters left, so maybe for the rest of the year. I think the extension of the mask mandate will help from saving kids from COVID and also from the fact of we get to stay in school, so I think that's a good thing.
The mandate has affected my life. I wouldn't say negatively or positively. I guess it's fine. I mean, as long as we're doing it to stop a global pandemic.
The mandate has been affecting us for a little while now. I can't wait until it's over. Maybe for second semester, we'll be back to normal.
Our football team is really taking off this year.
We decided to ask some of the players and coaches how they're feeling about the season so far.
I think just early on, at the beginning of COVID, it was tough just because of all the protocols and procedures that we had to go through with temp checks and the paperwork and all those kinds of things. This season was a little bit better as far as with summer and all that kind of stuff, where we didn't have to do that, even though we still checked in with our crew and continue to talk about, you know, staying healthy and what that looks like and symptoms and all that kind of stuff. I think just noticing socially and, you know, emotionally was different for each and every kid. And so we've tried to take that into consideration based upon different families' structures and what that looks like for them. So it's just been kind of a lot all at once, but taking it case by case for sure.
Something that prepared me most, just the help from my coaches in the off season, and a lot of my teammates and I went and lifted with each other in the off season as well. So just getting prepared for lifting and getting back in shape due to the help of my coaches and my teammates has definitely helped me out.
For sure, we're going to compete every single day at practice with each other, and then on game days all the way through. Our MO is we're just going to keep, you know, keep being the hammer and see what happens. We don't really focus on the result. We much rather focus on the process of what gets us to the result that we're wanting. So we're just continuing to get better and play together as a whole team.
Wow, what a change. I'll be sure to go to the next game. Go Cougars.
Believe it or not, teachers have lives out of school. Some of them even have hobbies and talents.
Our own Miss Barnett, who happens to be choreographing the school musical, was kind enough to share one of her hobbies, dancing, which she has been doing since she was 3 and has now moved up to teaching at the studio.
So I began dancing when I was 3 years old, like a lot of little girls. I was mainly trained in classical ballet, but I also trained in jazz and lyrical and a little bit of acrobatics. I danced professionally for a while. I loved performing right out of high school, but I decided to go back to school. And I became a math major because I didn't know what else to do, and that's when I started teaching dance also. So right now, I am the competition team director at Dance Unlimited. It's up north by Chapel Hills Mall. I really like teaching dance too because it's a really nice way to keep dance alive in my life. It's always been a passion of mine. My favorite to teach would be lyrical. It's kind of a blend of ballet and jazz technique. We've had a lot of winning dances, which is really exciting. Right now, we are in the top 9 dances in the nation for the Industry Dance Awards. Even making it to the top 9 out of thousands of dances is pretty insane. So I'm very proud of my team. It's never too late to start dancing. As long as you're passionate about dancing, you can start at any time.
Mrs. Barnett is also helping choreograph the school musical Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, come see Wizard of Oz. Maybe you'll recognize some of my stuff, maybe not, but I hope you enjoy the show.
Wow, that was quite the story. Thanks for sharing, Miss Barnett. Be on the lookout for Wizard of Oz coming soon.
Well, that wraps up another episode of Cougar TV. Join us next week to find out what's happening in your hallways. I'm Maxwell Howland.
And I'm Christian Morrow.
Stay classy, Coronado!